One of the Emotion Code Divas, Helena Denikin, and I have started the Emotion Code Diva show, which we are showing every doing every Wednesday morning at 9:30 a.m. Pacific time, and we walk through the 7 keys to doing Emotion Code. And today, I wanted to talk to you in particular about chakras. I've worked with chakras for years and years, and have found that the energy that can get blocked in those chakras has a lot to do with trapped emotions. And once I learned what the trapped emotions were all about, learning the becoming an emotion code practitioner, I understood the similarities and how working with the chakras individually can actually release trapped emotions. So the first thing I'll go through is just what we actually go through when we are looking at doing emotion code. So the first thing that we need to do when we're working with someone, and we could be working with someone with emotional pain or physical pain. I've been working a lot with women lately. I work with women entrepreneurs, but in particular, many of them have been struggling to find their voice. So that's something that resides in the throat chakra, which we'll talk about in a minute. But I've used emotion code to work on that. So when I work with someone, which is either by telephone or Skype or Zoom or video chatting through Facebook or something, but the first thing that I'm going to ask if they're not with me is that I can have permission. So when I ask permission, it just means, may I become your, well, we're just moving into that. Do I have permission to work with you? But I'm going to ask that I could become a person's proxy. And what this means is, just like in a board meeting, if you're not able to attend, you give someone else permission to vote for you. In this case, someone is giving me their permission. Could be a person, or it could be someone's pet that they have chakras as well, but it could be somebody's pet who is just not doing very well. So they would then become the surrogate. And I would become the proxy to work with the animal. The next thing that I'm going to ask is, what's the severity of the problem? So are we looking at, chances are nothing's going to be down in the lower area. It's going to be usually an 8, 9, or 10. And I will also muscle test it and just check with what the person has told me. But once I have the proxy and I tap into their subconscious, then I want to find out. And then the next thing I'm going to do when I'm actually going through the chart of emotions is I'm going to do the muscle testing. So this is where I've become their proxy. So I can do the muscle testing on myself. And the way that I do muscle testing is probably different. There's lots of different methods that Dr. Bradley Nelson talks about in his book. You can buy his book, The Emotion Code. And the method that I use is simply I have my fingers like that. And then I put these two through. You don't need much pressure at all. So I'm just going to go ahead and say, I was to get a yes. This is a yes. It's nice and tight. And that's a no. So when I'm going through the trapped emotions, I get a yes or I get a no. So I would do muscle testing for me looks like this. So I might say, am I Dana? If I want to be someone else's proxy, then I am I Dana, am I Dana? And say I'm working with someone named Susan. And I would say, am I Susan? Am I Susan? Am I Susan? Am I Susan? So now I've got a nice tight connection with Susan. So I'm now going to be doing the muscle testing on myself. And what I do when I go through the chart of emotions, so this is the emotion code chart, I'm going to ask if the subconscious, is it in column A? Is it in column B? And is it an even or an odd row? And I just go through that fairly quickly. So once I've gone through that and found where the trapped emotion is, then I use a magnet. And these are the magnets that I've got. I've got different magnets that I use, but for different things, but these are the ones I use most often. And what I'm doing in terms of releasing that trapped emotion is we have a governing meridian that goes from about the top of our lip all the way down to our spine. But when I'm doing it and I'm seated, I'm just going to go ahead, and when that emotion comes up, the magnets actually demagnetize it. So we pull it up. It's kind of like that credit card, you know, if you get it demagnetized, in your wallet or something. It just won't work. Well, this is what we're doing with these trapped emotions. So I'm going to do three swipes. If it's their emotion, it can be, the emotion can be trapped during conception, preconception. It can be inherited, or it can happen anytime in a person's lifetime. And you can have the same trapped emotion throughout your body. It just gets triggered from different situations. So I use the emotion code chart. I do the magnet like that. If it's inherited, I do 10 swipes. And then something that I always want to make sure of is that I'm very hydrated and that the person I'm working with is hydrated as well. So let's move on into talking about the chakras. So we have actually hundreds of chakras, but most people are most familiar with the seven chakras. So that's what I'm actually going to be showing you how I work with that. So if we look at the chakras in the body, we've got the crown chakra, which is there. So the crown chakra is the area on top of your head. It has a color. It is also the crown chakra. If there's any trapped emotions where you're not feeling spiritually connected, this is where the imbalance occurs. Then we'll take a look at the third eye chakra. So that's right here. And that just means that if that's blocked, you're not listening to your intuition, you're not being guided, you're not trusting yourself, you're second guessing. And sometimes it can also mean that you're lacking connection in your life and meaning. So each of these can also bring on a physical symptoms, as well as emotional emotions that are trapped there. So the next chakra is the throat chakra. And this is the throat chakra where I was working with someone today, and we wanted her to be able to speak her truth. So I connected with that throat chakra, and we find quite a few trapped emotions that were there. And the next one, as we move down, is into the heart chakra. So heart chakra is all about receiving and giving love. If you're feeling blocked, if your relationships aren't going well, then that can also be part of that. The Emotion Code Divas are doing a series of Facebook broadcasts on relationships. So be sure to check us out there. We also will be posting this up on our YouTube channels as well. So there's the heart chakra. And then we move down into the solar plexus area. So this is just below, for women, it's just below your breast, but it's above your belly button. So that's the area that solar plexus chakra is where, this is where the courage comes from. This is where the power comes from. This is where you can speak your truth and really stand in your truth as well. And then we move on to the sacral chakra. So you can, in the sacral chakra, this is where most of the sexual emotions reside, creativity as well as fun. So if you find that you're kind of dull or the sexual relationship isn't working too well, chances are you've got some trapped emotions in the sacral area. And the last chakra that I work with is the root chakra. So the root chakra, you know, if you're feeling stuck and sluggish, if you're having a lot of financial problems, financial concerns, or feeling that you don't belong anywhere in the world, then most likely they are blocked in your root chakra. So what I do is test that, and I would say to the person, let's say I sometimes do go through the whole list. So I start with the crown, and I might say, are there any trapped emotions in the crown chakra? So if I get a no, then I don't have to go there. Are there any trapped emotions in the third eye chakra? No, I don't have to go there. Are there any trapped emotions in the throat chakra? So I get a big yes on that. So then what I start doing is I just use, again, I go back to the emotion code chart, and I will just do, is it column A? No, is it B? Is it, I often close my eyes when I'm doing it because I just find I actually get numbers or words in front of me, but I'll just say, is it in column A? No. Is it in B? Yes. Is it even? No, it's odd. Is it 1, 3, 5? Is it 3? 3, it's 3. Is it confusion, defensiveness, grief, self-abuse, stubbornness? I go back. Is it confusion? It's confusion. I'm getting a tight one, a tight connection with confusion. So I ask the question, does this belong to this person? Does this belong to me? Because again, I'm the proxy for that person. Does this belong to me? It's a yes. Can I clear this emotion now? And that's a yes. So then I take my magnet and I just do the three swipes of the magnet like that. And then I found out and I asked the question, did I release that trapped emotion? Yes. All right. Are there others that I can release? Yes. So then I go through the same thing. Are they in column A? Are they in column B? Is it even? It's even. So then it's 2, 4, 6. And again, I'm just looking at my chart, and what I'm looking at are the even numbers. Is it in 2, 4, or 6? And then I've asked which column it's in, and then I'll go through it. So I might say, is it humiliation, jealousy, longing, lust, overwhelm? Is it humiliation, jealousy, jealousy? So I'm getting a definite yes on the jealousy. So then I ask, does this emotion belong to this person? No. If I get a no, then the next question I'm going to ask, is it inherited? So is this inherited? Yes. And then I'll say, is it inherited on the mother's side? No. Is it inherited on the father's side? Yes. Is it on the father's mother's side? No. Father's father. And I just go through the generations, because once we can release that from the grandfather, the father, and through that person, it will no longer be carried on to any children if that person is going to have any. So that's just a brief overview of what the how I work with the chakras. And even though I predominantly work with women that are in business, we all feel imbalances in our life, in our personal life, as well as our business life. So if you're interested in finding out more about me, you can go to empoweredwomeninbusiness.com/emotion-code. And if you want to connect with my emotion diva partner, Helena Jenikin, you can go to flourishhypnosis.com/emotion-code. And either one of us would love to help you. We each have different skills and tools and different sacred gifts. So so if you're feeling out of balance, please, only you can find the happiness in your life, because it has to be something that comes from the inside and goes out. So thank you. Love to hear your comments, and feel free to share the Emotion Code Diva Show live, facebook.com/TEC Divas. And we are live every Wednesday morning at 9:30. So you have to wait till the show actually goes live before you can watch us. So that is it for now. Thank you.